A Happy Pocket Full of Money by David Cameron Gikandi, read by John Wayne Myers. Disc 1. There is a science of getting rich, and it is an exact science, like algebra or arithmetic. There are certain laws which govern the process of acquiring riches, and once these laws are learned and obeyed by anyone, that person will get rich with mathematical certainty. Wallace D. Wattles. Money, an illusion, a shadow of something else. The first step to having wealth is to know what it is. And few people know what it really is, in and of itself. What is wealth? What causes it? What causes the cause of it? Let us start with money, the world's symbol of wealth, and then move deeper. Money is not real. Money is merely legal tender, a form of exchange. We use it to exchange value. It represents value. Money is the body of value. It is the physical representation of value that rises and falls in ourselves, within us. Not within things outside of us, but within us. For without us, what can the value of a thing, such as a car, be to us? Nothing, at least not to us. In other words, it is we, the observers, that place value in things. But this value is really value in us. We give value to the material things. The material things have no money value in themselves. We give that to them. So, money is the external physical representation of a particular section of our internal value within us, within you. That is why a house or a block of shares valued at $1 million today can fall to a valuation of $500,000 tomorrow when fear is introduced into the hearts of those involved. The fear kills a portion of the internal values of the participants, and that is reflected by the paper money, the body of value. Here is something else. Physical paper money does not even represent money in full. It cannot reasonably do that. By some estimates, and this varies from nation to nation, only as little as 4% of the money in the bank exists as paper cash. Imagine how much cotton, linen, pulp, and metal the world would need so as to make all the money everyone has in his or her bank accounts. Imagine how much space it would take to store all this money in paper form. If you were to stack only 1 million U.S. $1 bills, it would weigh 1 ton and be 361 feet high. Neither does money exist as gold reserves anymore. This is for exactly the same reason. We ran out of the reasonable ability to keep a gold standard in the 1970s. So what does it exist as, the money that we are always talking about? Well, it is one massive illusion. It is all just numbers written on paper and computer storage devices and assigned to people and entities such as companies and investments, or more accurately, further records. To put it in another way, for every $100 or its equivalent in any other currency, only about $4 exists as printed paper notes or coins, while the remaining $96 exists as numbers written on papers and computers in banks and businesses and other entities. The only reason the system does not collapse is that we all believe in it. The last time people stopped believing in it to a large enough extent was just before the Great Depression, when large numbers of people rushed to their banks to withdraw their money and found that they could not all get it. This is not what caused the Great Depression, but in a large way accelerated it. So money is not real. Something else is. Money is just the shadow of that other something. The first step to wealth is to know what money really is, or more accurately, what it represents. Learn not to look at the money most of the time. As you will soon see, it is very rare in a day that you should ever look at money as you know it today. The cash, the bank accounts, the costs, etc. This is merely the shadow and not the real thing. Looking at the shadow, the physical money, as you will soon see, is most of the time very unwise and unhealthy for you and your finances. Look instead at the value within you and within people, and the flowing and exchanging of this value between people. Our internal value is what creates money. Money is the shadow of our internal value. Develop this internal value in yourself and in others, and your external money and wealth will correspondingly rise automatically without fail. Know this, however. Money represents an aspect of a person's internal value, but that does not mean that it represents a person's entire internal value. That is very important. It is not about self-worth. Money only represents an aspect of that internal value that pertains to wealth. You cannot therefore say that a wealthy person has a higher self-worth and value than a poor person, but you can correctly say that in matters that relate and pertain to money, the wealthy person has a higher internal value in that aspect of value, or that the person chooses to exercise a higher proportion of this internal value. This section of internal value that reflects on the outside as money, when exercised, is called wealth consciousness. It is available to all people equally and can be developed by and within all people equally. Like everything else that is important to our being alive, such as air, wealth consciousness is free to all. But you can choose to develop it or not develop it, or to exercise it or not. At any time, you can change your choice and nothing outside of you can stop you. You require nothing outside of yourself to increase your wealth consciousness and therefore your money. All you need is within you right now. You may have forgotten it, but it is right there. You will now remember it. And the first step to that is to always remember that money is not real. It is the shadow of something else. And here's another secret. Wealth consciousness is simply the expansion of your consciousness and awareness into the wealthy parts of yourself. That is why all that you need to increase your wealth consciousness is within you already. You are already wealthy, but you've been taught to choose to not experience your wealth. This insight changes everything. Like the wealthy people, you can now know how to start and choose to start experiencing the wealthy you. You have more wealth capability within you than you can possibly experience in a lifetime. You need not worry that you have reached your limit of becoming wealthy in any way or because of any condition. Neither do you need to know how to convert wealth consciousness into paper cash money. As you will see, it will happen automatically. All you need to do is expand your wealth consciousness and exercise it, act on it, be it, and the situations and opportunities for the equivalent conversion into cash money will present themselves automatically to you. None of the extremely wealthy people today could have, at the time when they were not wealthy, possibly predicted and planned the exact sequence of events that would lead to their immense wealth. They most probably had a set of goals and a plan, but any one of them will tell you that they met countless coincidences and opportunities that joined the dots for them in a way that they could not have predicted. Their goals were their own doing, but the paths that led them coming into being and exceeding them were amazingly intelligent yet unforeseen. You should now see how to make them happen in your life. You may not be able to predict their sequence, but you can certainly make these fortunate coincidences happen to you every day of your life. By the way, it is not only paper money that is not real. A lot of the things around you that you hold so real are really not real at all either. You are about to embark on a beautiful, empowering, and liberating journey that will show you exactly what your world is in a way that you have never looked at it before. It is a journey that will open your eyes and free your wings. You are about to look under the hood of life. You are about to learn how to customize your world to your liking. You are about to attain wealth consciousness. Once you do, avoiding success and wealth will become very difficult. Yes, you heard that correctly. Once you have wealth consciousness, it will be very difficult for you to not have success and wealth. Success and wealth will follow you automatically wherever you go. You will not need to concern yourself with their quest, yet they will find you. You will be free to experience other aspects of life that you may not have ever dreamt of before, dimensions of self and life that are truly amazing. The same goes with happiness, for you will see it here in this book as well. Let us now get started on the real stuff, if you are still interested. The steps to wealth and happiness. You are now on a journey, at the end of which you shall know how to create all the wealth and happiness you ever wished for. Now, without any limits. You shall soon also know many timeless truths about who you really are, what you are doing here, and what this game of life is all about. Here are the steps of the journey that you are now taking with this book. Number 1. You shall first take a simplified look at quantum physics, for knowing what you and the world are made of is the first key to knowing how to make it your way. After this, you will never look at the world in the same way again. You shall have an amazing sense of involvement and power in the universe. Number 2. Then the secrets of time shall be unveiled, beginning with the fact that time does not exist. You shall learn how to use this illusion instead of being used by it. There is only now.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.